Welcome to a new video. This tutorial will show you how to repair Audi A4, B6 and B7 instrument clusters using Minitools replacement LCD. For this repair, you will need the following tools. Position the dashboard as shown and undo the screws with the Torx screwdriver. With the head of the spudger, pry on the side clips and remove the rear cover. Unplug the four connectors of the side gauges from the board and remove the front cover. Place the gauge face protective disc underneath the needles, which you remove rotating them anti-clockwise and gently pulling. Then, release the board from the white plastic by acting on the clips. From the rear side of the PCB, undo the clips of the metal frame of the display. With the spudger, open the FPC connector and remove the display with its housing. With the head of the tweezers, unclip and take off the frame of the LCD, which you then remove from the housing. Peel off the films from the Minitools display and place it correctly. Fit the metal frame. Insert the FPC into its connector and fix the display on the board. Carefully follow the following instructions before reassembling the dashboard. Switch on the panel. Identify the PCB corresponding to the instrument panel you're repairing. With a multimeter, measure the voltage between the points indicated and take note of it. If the voltage measured is between 7.0 and 7.2 volts, the problem is solved. Otherwise, to adjust the voltage and the display contrast, it will be necessary to do a modification of the EEPROM24C08, highlighted in the picture with a specific programmer. Switch off the dashboard. Memorize the EEPROM soldering direction, as it has to be soldered back exactly the same way. With a hot air desoldering iron, desolder the EEPROM with the head of the tweezers. Clip the EEPROM, connecting it to the programmer. Set the reading in hexadecimal and make a backup. Identify on the EEPROM the location 039B. Scanning the QR code or following the link on the product label, open the PDF with the instructions, so to use the specific calculation tool to do the modification. To carry out the modification correctly, type in the values related to your defective dashboard. Those used in the video are for illustrative purpose only. Type in the first box on the upper right side, the value of the voltage measured before. In this case, the voltage was 7.63 volts. Then type in the related boxes the values of the location indicated. You will automatically get the new values to type in the location. Save the file just modified and upload it on the EEPROM. Unclip the EEPROM from the programmer. Before soldering it back, remove the tin excess from the PCB with the soldering iron with chisel tip at 350 degrees and a solder wick. Clean with some solvent. With the tweezers, position the EEPROM on the board as it was originally, and solder it using thin solder wire and a soldering iron with conical tip at 350 degrees. Clean with some solvent. Switch on the dashboard again, and with the multimeter, recheck the voltage between the points indicated before. If, as in this case, the voltage is now between 7.0 and 7.2 volts, the modification was successful. If the voltage has not changed after the EEPROM modification, we recommend contacting us by mail at info@minitools.com. Reattach the base with the side screens and the faceplate to the board. Put back the needles and with the head of the Minitools shim, push them at the right level. Then, bring them back to their original position. Place the board into the front cover and reconnect the connectors of the side gauges. fit the rear cover and tighten the screws. Switch on the dashboard. Perfetto! Problem solved! Thank you for choosing MiniTools.